Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How-To, and today we're going to be talking about the Perspective Grid tool and the Perspective Selection tool, and they kind of work hand in hand, so we'll go over a few ways to use both. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm here in Illustrator. I'm just going to create a new document, and I'm going to come over to Print, and we'll choose Letter and Create. First, we're going to open the Perspective Grid tool. So when you click on this, this Perspective Grid will show up on your canvas. Now, if you want to turn this off, you can just hit Shift-Command-I or Shift-Control-I on a PC to toggle that on and off. And you'll see this little guy up in the corner. That might be hidden if your screen isn't docked like this, but usually you'll see this up here. Now with this perspective tool, we have the option of having 1-point perspective, 2-point, or 3-point. And to get to that, you can just go to View, Perspective Grid. You can also hide the grid, and here's that keyboard shortcut. But you can choose 1-point perspective, 2-point perspective, or 3-point. Here's what 1-point perspective looks like. 2-point, and 3-point. I'm gonna go ahead and put it back on the 2-point perspective. Make sure that you're clicked on your Perspective Grid tool, and you'll be able to see all of these little handles that you can pull around. Now this one is going to change the perspective. For the bottom, you change the perspective with this lower one. You can change your perspective plane by clicking this white one down here. To make the side of your grid a little shorter or longer, you can pull on this diamond. These outer circles will squeeze it. And then these two little dots down here, you can actually separate the two sides. Maybe you're wanting to make a fence or something, I don't know. So I'm gonna line those back up again. If you adjust this diamond down here at the bottom, it's going to change the number of grid lines. Once you get the grid the way you like it, if you find that you're using the same grid a lot, you can go up here to View, Perspective Grid, and actually save that as a preset. And if you want to reset your 2-point perspective grid, you can just choose this and it'll reset it to the original default. So we'll start with that. Now there are two different ways to use the perspective grid tool. First is you can actually use your shapes to draw right on that grid. So let's try that. If I click on my rectangle tool, I can drag in the selected area, which right now this little icon is showing that blue, this left side, is the selected area, and everything I draw will be kind of based on this area. So if I draw a square here, it's going to follow that grid. If I draw it over here on the orange side, it's still going to follow that blue selection. So I'm going to undo that one. I'll click on this and we'll give this a different color. You can draw with any of these shapes and it'll match the grid. So let's draw a star down here. I'm holding shift so that it stays upright. But you can see that it follows the grid. Now, if I want to move this star around, if I hit V and move it, you'll notice it doesn't change to the size of the grid. So I'm going to undo, and this is where the perspective selection tool comes in. And the keyboard shortcut for that is Shift V. So now we've got this selected. So this just works as a selection tool, just like this would, but it'll adjust to what the grid is. So if I move it down here, it's getting bigger and it's following the grid lines. We'll just move it here. And same with this, we can move it and it'll follow that grid line. Now I'm gonna go ahead and draw something over on the orange side. So I'll click that up here on the icon. You have to make sure you have either a perspective selection tool or the perspective grid tool selected in order to be able to do this. So I'm going to get some red. And we'll use the polygon tool. I'm gonna hold shift so I keep it in the same upright position. If you're used to hitting V, you'll notice that it doesn't wanna follow that anymore. So just undo and hit shift V, and then you can change the position on the grid. And we'll turn it off and see how that looks. Well, it's not very exciting. So let's go ahead and create something that will make it a little more obvious what we're doing. I'm gonna get green. A square and start right up here from the top, and then I'll send it back. Well, let's change this. I'm going to change this to light green, and I'll click on this one over here to get back on my blue sector. I'm going to click this green and draw this side. Okay, so I went a little too far down here. We'll have to use our Shift V selection tool to get this to move up. We'll just pull this down, and now we've got everything lining up fine. I'm going to send this to the back. Oh, that's terrible. Let's change these to a little lighter color. Okay, so now if we turn our grid off by hitting Shift Command I or Shift Control I on a PC, you can see that everything is perfectly aligned to that grid. I'm going to hit Command A and delete this because I really don't need that. I'm going to hit Shift Command I to bring that grid back. And now I want to show you how to actually take flat graphics and assign them to a side. So to do this, I've already got a couple graphics prepared. I'll just open those now. So I'm going to put this on the left side. I'm going to copy that. And I'll make sure that that upper part is clicked. If you can't select it, you need to change your tool to one of the perspective tools. So I've got this selected. I'm going to paste this in and then hit Shift V to get on your perspective selection tool. And then hold Shift and drag it into place. And now we can size this up. And now we'll go grab the other one. Whoops. Copy that. I'll hit Shift V to get on a perspective tool. And then I'll click over here on the orange part, paste, hit Shift V, hold Shift, and now we can resize that side. And this is something that you'll need to play with a little bit. Everything seems to be a little too close to this edge for my liking, so we can use our perspective selection to kind of move this over. Whoops. Maybe pull this one a little bit this way. You don't have to expand these or anything like that. They're just regular shapes, so you don't really need to worry about that. And I think this tool is really great just once you get the hang of it, but it takes a little bit of time to really get it down and get those keyboard shortcuts too. All right, that's my video for this week. If you liked it, please click the like button, and I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.